Hello guys, thank you so much for clicking on today's video. My name is Emma and I'm so happy to see you. Today's video, I'm going to be sharing how to get monetized. I'm going to be explaining the entire process so that you can understand when it's your turn if you're a small YouTuber. And I'm also going to be sharing my tips and how much I got paid for my first ever YouTube paycheck. If you're interested in absolutely anything YouTube monetization and you need some help, or you're just curious to hear about it, I'm here to help you out. Feel free to check out my Etsy and my social media if you'd like, and to support my channel, it would mean the world. Subscribe and like once you find a tip that helps you and if you like the channel. If you're not aware, monetization just means the fact that you are monetized or making money from YouTube. To make money from YouTube, there are a few requirements that you will need: 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours, which is 240,000 minutes in the span of 365 days, a rolling year. What that means is you have to have those two criteria in a span of 365 days. So say on the 365th day that you've been trying to get this criteria, and on the 366th day, the watch hours that you got on the first day don't count anymore, but the ones on the 366th do. Hopefully that makes sense, but it's just a rolling clock. You can check your watch hours in your YouTube studio, and you can click the drop-down box in the last 365 days, and that's the little time span that you need to get those 4,000 watch hours. There's another criteria that not a lot of people talk about, but you need to live in a country that is eligible for monetization. Now, you can look that up and see if your country can be monetized. For example, if you live in the US, you can get monetized, and there's an entire list of countries that can be, but just double check that you live in a country that can get paid. I'm going to start by giving you guys some tips on how to get monetized if you're not yet there, how to get those watch hours and subscribers, and how to keep moving up to get the criteria first. The first point that I want to make is don't make super short videos. I feel like many people in the beginning of their YouTube journey tend to make videos that are like 4 or 5 minutes, but for someone like you who is trying to rush and get those watch hours and subscribers, something that's going to help your engagement, which is directly leading to how many hours and minutes people are watching your videos, is making longer videos. I would really recommend making videos around 10 to 13 minutes. I feel like that's the sweet spot, but I really, really don't recommend making videos that are anywhere under 8 minutes, but obviously don't make a 40-minute video either. To get more watch hours, you're going to need consistent videos. You're going to need long-ish videos so that you have people that are watching for a long time, but those videos also need to be engaging and entertaining, because it doesn't matter if it's 20 minutes or if it's 10, it's not going to make a difference in your watch hours if people are leaving within the first 30 seconds. Every video that you make has an average watch time, and say it's 50% of your video. If you make an 8-minute video, that would mean it has 4 minutes. But if you make a 12-minute video, that's already 6 minutes, which is 2 minutes more than the shorter video. I hope you get what I'm saying. The longer the video is, the longer the percentage of watch time is as well. I've talked about this in my previous video on how to gain 1,000 subscribers. You can go check it out after this one, but you need engaging videos. Have texts and pop-ups and editing and words on the screen to just accentuate what you're saying, and lots of other effects like that while you're editing. This will entertain the viewer and keep them watching the video for longer, which is something that's really necessary when you're pushing for those 4,000 watch hours. Also, remember to keep your intro and outro fairly short and just get to the point, because people are most likely going to skip it or click off anyway. Now, my next tip is super important. It's consistency. I'm sure you've heard it before, but it doesn't just mean posting videos at a consistent schedule. It means consistently improving your videos and consistently getting better while posting relatively often. Some people might struggle with the 1,000 subscribers more, and some people might struggle with the 4,000 watch hours more. For me, the 4,000 watch hours took slightly longer than 1,000 subscribers, so consistency is really going to be your best friend to getting there. If I had to estimate an amount of videos to have on your channel around the time that you might get monetized, of course the process is different for everyone, but if I had to pick, I would say around 50 videos in 1 year might get you close to those criteria to get monetized. This would mean you are posting on your channel at least once a week, and whenever you get the chance, you would post twice a week. This should get you to enough videos because, like I said, you have 365 days to get those watch hours, and I feel like once you post 50 videos on your channel, it really starts to kind of take off and skyrocket. So definitely aim for at least once a week while you're in that process. Now, if you want to improve your engagement quality and you want to know what people are enjoying on your videos and what they're not enjoying, you can go to your YouTube Studio Analytics. If you don't have that app yet, definitely download it. You're going to need it. Every time you post a video after it's been up for a few hours or days, check your analytics and see what your viewers are thinking of the video. You can check the watch time and you can actually see the exact point at which your viewers are clicking out of your video. Maybe you notice a huge dip in watch time in a certain video and you can pinpoint where it is. Maybe you rambled for too long or your audio got bad or you had a song too loud, and you can kind of tell why a lot of people are clicking, why a lot of people are clicking off of your video. This can help you because you now know things to improve, or you know if your intro is too long and that kind of thing, so that for the next video that you upload, you keep on improving something. This is not always the case, but sometimes the views and the amount of time that viewers are watching can indicate if they like the topic of videos. So say all the hauls in your videos seem to have a little bit more views, it might mean that your subscribers are more interested in seeing hauls. So push those out and maybe one of them will blow up, which is so beneficial for getting monetized. Like I said, I made a video before this about how to reach 1,000 subscribers and just lots of tips for growth. So definitely go check it out after this one and you can get even more tips that will help you out. I also wanted to mention that everyone's journey is so different. So please try not to compare yourself to other people's success and other people's views and everything like that, because truly everything is going to be different. Somebody might get monetized in 3 months and for you, it might take 2-3 years. You know, you really can't pinpoint exactly when that's going to happen for you, but just stay strong and keep working hard if it's your passion. Also, make sure that you're trying to avoid copyrighted clips or copyrighted songs. You definitely want to make sure that your videos don't have 3 million copyright strikes left and right, because obviously YouTube, when they look at your channel, they're going to think something's fishy and it might make your process a little bit harder. So use copyright-free songs and just keep on improving if you can. Something else that you could do to help you out is download TubeBuddy. TubeBuddy is an app and tool that can really help you out through your YouTube journey. And through TubeBuddy, you can monitor your views and your likes and all of that kind of thing. But you can also add tags to your videos, which I really recommend doing. Tags are words and phrases that are relevant to your video and that make it more discoverable through search engines and the algorithm on YouTube. So I definitely recommend adding those if you want your videos to be more shown and to grow. Okay, so now we've gotten to the interesting part. We're gonna talk about what to do after you reach your 4,000 watch hours and your 1,000 subscribers in that period of a year. If you haven't reached the criteria yet, I still recommend watching so that you can learn a little bit more about it or come back to it when that time comes. So now you have got your 240,000 minutes and you need to go through the YouTube steps to get yourself monetized. Go on your laptop, go into your YouTube studio, and you can go into the monetization tab to go ahead and enable it. Then you're gonna have 3 steps that YouTube is going to require you to do. The first one will be to review and allow the YouTube terms. You're basically just gonna have to read some terms and conditions and make sure that you agree to all of that. Definitely read those and educate yourself about things that you are going to need to know. Step 2 is going to be setting up your AdSense account. If you didn't know, AdSense is what you're getting paid from, so you're going to need an account that is connected to your YouTube channel so that advertisements can be placed on your videos for you to make money. You don't need to reach all the requirements to make an AdSense account, and I honestly recommend making an account now even if you haven't reached it. It'll make the process so much quicker and so much smoother. Just make a login and a password that you're going to remember. I recommend doing the same thing that you did for your YouTube channel and just connecting those accounts so that you're ready once you get there. But if you haven't made it, there will be a button in the YouTube studio to tell you how to do it, and it'll walk you through with instructions and all those kinds of things. Once you did the first 2 steps, the 3rd step is going to be to get reviewed by YouTube. Now, this step is no longer in your hands. YouTube is now going to look over your channel and make sure that you are eligible for monetization, make sure there's nothing weird or sketchy going on in your channel so that they know that your channel is safe to put ads on and for you to make money. This process can take anywhere from like 2 days to 30 days even. It really varies. It took me 2 to 3 days for YouTube to review my application for monetization and I got approved, but just stay patient. After you get approved, you're going to need to put in your address for YouTube. And the reason YouTube needs your address is because they're going to send you a piece of paper. This is the piece of paper or little envelope that many people hold up for the thumbnails in these videos. And there's no money in this. The point of this paper is to confirm your address and make sure that they've got the right person. It's honestly just legal stuff, but once you do get the paper, you're going to have a little box to put a pin. And when you open this piece of paper, there's going to be a little pin in there and you can put the pin onto the box to confirm that they've got the correct address. And once that's done, they're going to need your bank account information because that's actually where you're getting paid from. You're not going to get paid through mail or through paper checks. It's just going to be deposited into the bank account. If you're under 18, you can use your parents' bank account. It will go directly to them, but you can have them save that money for you and put that on the side. But you do need a bank account. Some people might also need their account to be confirmed, so they might put in like a few cents and ask you for the amount that was put in, just to make sure that they have the right account. Again, there's a lot of confirming and stuff that needs to be done, but that's just for your safety. After that, you're basically going to be ready to put ads in your videos. To do that, you can go into your video details on YouTube Studio, go into the monetization tab, and pick the ads that you want. There's different ad options like bumper ads, skippable ads, non-skippable ads, and you can check off yourself which type of ads you would like to show up on your video. Personally, I checked off all of them, but it is your choice. And then you should be able to add mid-rolls into your video. Once you find that, you can click it and you can manually add advertisements into your videos. Say you want an ad at 5 minutes and another ad at 9 minutes and anything like that, so you could place your ads. Personally, I place my ads a little bit before most people click off on average, and then I like to do ads about every 5 minutes as well, so that it's not too many ads to the point where people click off, but you're still placing enough ads to make money. And while we're talking about ads, it means so much if you guys watch the ads or click them or don't skip them in general, just because that's the only way that I'm making money from YouTube basically. So I really appreciate your support if you do that. That's why YouTubers ask for you to watch the ads, and if you watch my ads, I will love you forever because it really helps me out. Okay, so now you have your ads running and everything is set up, but to actually get your YouTube paycheck, you need to reach a threshold of $100 in 1 month. Now this can take you quite a while if you're not making $100 per month. But again, just place your ads, enable monetization in previous videos, and don't have copyright because you can't monetize copyrighted videos. If you have a video that's doing well or that blew up or something, this is going to make it easier for you to reach those $100. You have from the first of a certain month to the last day of that month to make those $100 minimum, or you won't get paid. The money that you do make, though, will roll over to the next month whenever you reach $100, and you will make that plus the amount of the previous month that didn't quite reach the threshold. So, say you reached $110 in a month, you just made it, this is how the payment is going to work. For example, from the 1st to the last day of May, you made $110, you're going to be getting that deposit on the 21st of June. You're always going to be getting paid on the 21st of the month, the next month after. This is so that your payments can be confirmed and so that they can roll into your AdSense account. If you have the $100 and you're on the 21st of the month, that money will get deposited into the bank account that you added. It could be your parents' account or your bank account, but that's how the payment actually works. If, for example, you've been on AdSense and you're kind of freaking out because it says you have $0, but on the YouTube Studio, you can see that you have $150. The reason why it says $0 on AdSense for quite a long time is because your earnings are actually only going to be processed on about the second week of the month that you're getting paid. So your earnings from May are only going to be processed around the 10th through the 13th or 14th of June. So the money will show up, but it will have to be after those 2 weeks because your earnings need to be processed and confirmed. But again, even though that's not showing up, you can always check your earnings on the YouTube Studio. See, what I do is I go onto the earnings tab to see how much money I've made, and I check off just for the month of June or just for the month of May. And that's how you can actually see if you've reached the $100 minimum. All right, so next thing we're gonna talk about is my personal monetization experience, the timeline that it happened in, as well as how much money I made, before I go and do some more tips that you're going to need to know if you're in the process. I had a YouTube channel a few years ago, but I privated all those videos and I kind of started fresh, and I had 100 subscribers when I did that. I started my YouTube channel back up on December 27th of 2019 when I started taking my channel more seriously, and I was posting once to twice a week, which really helped. I reached all the monetization criteria that I needed to do. First, I reached my 1,000 subscribers, and then after, I reached the 4,000 watch hours in that year. And I got monetized in the fall of 2020. So this was approximately 7 months after I started my channel back up. So that's kind of how long it took me to monetize. So all of the growth that I needed happened in those 7 months. I actually only got my first ever YouTube paycheck on April 6th, 2021. I made $244 for my first ever YouTube paycheck. Now this money can vary. You can make just 100 or you can make thousands depending on if you have viral videos. But again, don't compare yourselves to any other amounts of money. The reason why I only got paid in April was because I made a few mistakes that I'm gonna tell you guys about so that you don't make the same mistakes as me, so that you can get paid as soon as possible. It took me a few months, and it wasn't really because I didn't reach the $100 threshold, it was because I was kind of confused about how the process worked. So the first mistake that I made is I did not put mid-rolls on my videos. I just had the regular ads running and I didn't monetize previous videos that were already on my channel. So I wasn't making money from my videos from December 2019 all the way to like before the fall 2020. So I just originally wasn't making enough. So definitely enable monetization for all of the videos that you have up previously, so that if they're gaining views and watch hours, you're getting that money. And make sure that all of your videos have mid-rolls if possible. Another mistake that slowed down my process was I didn't put in my tax information. When you're monetized, you need to log into your AdSense account, and there should be something that talks about taxes or just information in your process that isn't yet complete. There should be a little error at the top, and you should be able to click it so that you can put in your tax information. You are making money, so you're gonna need to pay taxes. It's not gonna be anything crazy because you're not making a lot of money in the beginning. But if you're a minor, get help from your parents so that you can input all that tax information. And if you're not, just make sure that you have that completed. I was making money on my YouTube studio, but it just wasn't coming in because I didn't fill out my tax information. So I'm here to help you out if you were also confused about that. All right, so the last section of this video is going to be explaining some tips that I wish I would have known and that you guys might need to know if you're confused in the process or getting there or anything like that. I touched on this before, but definitely make sure that you have chosen the ad types that you want on your videos, that you have your mid-rolls on, and that you don't go too crazy with the amount. I already talked about how many ads I put in and the kind of things that I do, but definitely don't put 10 ads in an 8-minute video. Of course, if you have a 20-minute video, it can take a little bit more ads than a 10-minute one. Okay, so this is something that actually happened to me, and I was absolutely freaking out during the 3-step process of getting approved for monetization. I did step one and it was pretty simple, and I made my AdSense account, but it just was not working for some reason. The step would not be checked off. So one, you need to make sure that your AdSense account is connected to your YouTube channel. And two, if you're under 18, there's this glitch or something that kind of happens to some people where it just doesn't let you get through. So something that I tested out that actually worked was I went into my settings on YouTube and I changed my age to make sure that I was over 18. When I did that, it finally let me move forward and put in the information that I needed to complete those steps. Of course, once you're done with the steps and you're being reviewed for monetization and you're moving forward with that process, change your age back to what it actually is. But for some reason, it wasn't working since I was under 18, and it's kind of weird with the accounts. Once you reach the steps, someone kind of asked me if you should wait to monetize your videos. Don't really do that, honestly. Once you've been reviewed and approved, just work hard and get on it really quick. Put ads in your videos, enable monetization, and just get going. This process can already take you a bunch of months, so you honestly just want to get ahead as much as possible. Even if you're not making money and reaching the requirements, it's important to still keep growing and still keep growing. Again, if you don't reach the $100 in 1 month threshold, then you're not gonna get paid the next month, but you're still going to be making money even if it's just a little bit from those ads. Maybe it takes you 3 months to reach the minimum of $100, but once you do that, payments from before will kind of roll over and you'll get paid. That's actually why I made $244. I would have made just a little over $100, but since I had a few months that I hadn't been paid yet, that payment rolled over and I got a bigger amount because I hadn't reached $100 in the previous months. So as far as I'm aware, they're not stealing your money. Again, don't just rely on the videos that you post after monetization. Make sure that you're getting some cash out of the videos that have already been uploaded, because the views and ad watches are not gonna make you any money if the monetization is literally not enabled. Another recommendation that I have for you guys, whether you're monetized or not, is to build other income streams. If you don't know what that means, it's basically where your money is going to be coming from. So you're not making too much money on AdSense, which is very reasonable. Definitely expand where you're getting your money from. I will be making a video in the future of ways to make money as a teenager and just in general. But for now, I want to say that there's ways to expand. You can have affiliate links where you make a percentage of money if somebody buys from your link. You can make money through super chats on live streams, which you will get an email about eventually, and you can enable those once you're eligible. You can do sponsorships, reach out to brands or answer their emails, and paid sponsorships are also a way to make money as a YouTuber, a great way, truly. And then you could do other little things like merch or having a Depop. You guys get what I'm saying, but just expand your money if you want to build your business. And the last tip for you guys, this is actually mostly for people who haven't reached the watch hours. Maybe you have 1,000 subs, but you're just not quite there on the watch hours yet. Aside from making videos that are searchable, popular, and that might get you some more views, and you can get some more tips from my previous video about how to reach 1,000 subs, if you need those watch hours, please ask your family and friends to watch your videos. Something that I do and that I truly recommend is making a playlist with every single video that you've ever posted. And this is actually something that maybe you can ask your mom or your dad to have playing in the background. If you have an old device or spare device that nobody is using, you're going to be getting so many more watch hours from just having your playlist constantly playing, constantly going, and your watch hours are going to skyrocket when you do that. You don't even need to be on there, but trust me guys, it's going to help you so much in getting those watch hours. Those are all the tips and information that I have for you guys. If you have any questions below, ask me and I will answer, and maybe I can even do a Q&A or something in the future to help you guys out. I love giving you tips about all these kinds of things, and I truly hope that they were able to help you. If they did, stop right there, scroll down, and give this video a thumbs up, please. It helps me so much. And I think after all these tips, you guys kind of understand why YouTubers ask people to subscribe and like and watch the ads. Please do that. It really is helpful, and it's our way to make money. I'm gonna be super transparent. In the last month or two, I haven't even gone over the 100 minimum, so I haven't been making that much money from YouTube. So if you want to support me, you can binge watch my all videos playlist in my channel. You can just not skip the ads, or you can click them, or just watch my entire video through. It really helps me out, and I would love to keep improving the quality of these videos for you guys. Make sure that you subscribed if this helped you out, and definitely share this YouTube video with some friends, maybe somebody else who's a YouTuber and who's trying to grow their channel, or if you have a YouTube group chat, go ahead and get this out there, because I hope that it can help as many people as possible. Please subscribe and turn on the notifications. I would love to have you back on my channel hanging out and watching more videos from me. I think that you will love them. Comments down below, everything just really helps me. You guys know what to do. Best of luck with your monetization process. And once you get there, it'll feel so much easier than it was. That's all for me from today. Make sure to take care of yourselves, drink some water. And remember, you are beautiful, you are amazing, you are loved, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye guys.